point, short films may have found a new media and a new way to kind of engage audiences?
Well, I mean, it's obviously here because I'm excited by the new opportunities. I mean, sure, now suddenly there was a venue for shorts. And so Sundance is committed to developing films for, I mean, as a development process. I think a lot of people are confused about Sundance. Sundance has got a few parts to it. But the big division is between the nonprofit and the profit. But there's a connection between the two. The nonprofit is strictly for development. The labs that we have at Sundance, we have a film lab, we have a theater lab, we have a documentary lab, we will have a shorts lab, we have a music composition lab. And they're all for independent new artists to come and work with established artists. And then they can go on and develop their own product. But it's nonprofit, therefore we can't get involved in the profit part of it. So last year, was exciting since this was a new venture. And we were all testing the waters, and GSM was bold enough to take this step and collaborate with us and say, okay, let's pick some artists that come out of the Sundance Institute and put their hand on and bring them to your Congress here with experimental films. But the thing to remember is that they were experimental. So the artists who came, what Sundance did was put their finger on the artist. They didn't actually, well, they were given money to produce them, but then we can't go any further. But they were experimental. It was a test. Say, well, what does this feel like? Do you see the possibilities here? So though they weren't so playing with story, they were more experimenting. This is what it could look like. This is what it could feel like. So this year, which is very exciting, we can take the next step because we move it to the Sundance Channel, which has the ability to distribute, but it has more responsibility in terms of the entertainment part of storytelling. So we have Isabella Rossellini's, Jody Shapiro's film here. That really takes it to the next level because it brings education and information into it, but still entertainment. It has to entertain, otherwise, what's the point? You might as well keep it in the classroom. So for us this year, being able to move it into the other part of Sundance, that's one of the reasons we're here.
And so we take a look at, again, an experiment last year, hopefully something much bigger, and we're experiencing that at the show today. Does mobile have the potential to challenge the traditional distribution landscape that you described as kind of being very commercial, loud trailers of a single film, driven by greed? Could you reach a point where maybe mobile, because of its unique kind of position and giving a chance to a different kind of filmmaker, can it ever be big enough to challenge Hollywood or the concept of Hollywood?
Well, I think Hollywood's too smart. Well, here we are with Hollywood again, but the business is too smart to be eclipsed. I noticed that with independent film. When I started the Sundance, there was no support from the mainstream at all. Couldn't get a dime. My colleagues in the industry. Then when we had the festival, no one came from the industry. But in time, once films started to work their way through and get into the marketplace, and they realized that they might be missing something, then they came. And then they started developing their own divisions for independent film, which didn't exist when I started. Now there's Searchlight, there's Focus, there's Paramount Independent, and Warner's has their independent film, which is great. I mean, I think it's terrific. The more, the better. But they were not that supportive to begin with. So when you get to shorts, I mean, I believe in shorts. I have huge belief in shorts. And because if you stop and think about it, it's been done before. Actually, it was done in comics books. When I was a kid growing up, I mean, I used to love reading the funny papers because you had four panels. And you had to tell a whole story in four panels, but they did. And that's why you kept reading them. That's why you read Little Apple. That's why you read because you had a beginning, middle, end, and you had to deliver drama, you had to deliver emotion, you had to satisfy, and you had to intrigue, and it works. That's just four panels. Which is really the same for a short. If you can, And I think what's exciting for filmmakers is the adjustments that they're going to be making to make the short. I think the disciplines you're going to have to put into play are going to be fabulous, because you're going to see whole new ways of storytelling coming. And also, you can take advantage of the shorter attention span, I guess, we're having with all this new technology and so forth. People not having much time. But I also don't think that we've explored all the possibilities yet. I think there's a lot more.
Now, have you, in your filmmaking career, have you made short films? You think you'll find yourself experimenting and building short films for mobile?
Yeah, we have at Sundance, one of the, how people come to Sundance are selected. Once we make the selections for people to come to our labs in June, the way they come is, I guess you would call it like an audition tape. You say, okay, make a short. Or if you've already made a short, it's a student, school, or what have you, send it. Let us see it. Then we look at the short and we see if we think there's talent there. It's not a question of how refined it is, that has little to do with it. It's just, can you see an independent voice? Can you see a voice of originality there that with our help can really get into the business? And then the other thing is that when they come, the first exercise that we give them is to make a short. And we give them one scene that you give to everybody. And it's a scene from John Cassavetes' film. And it's a restaurant scene. And you give it to everybody and you say, do whatever you want with the scene, but it's a short. So they all make these shorts, and then we look at what the different interpretations are of the same scene, which is pretty exciting. Then you get an idea about the breadth of possibilities for these filmmakers. But shorts are very much a part of what our process is at Sundance.
Do they make you do that John Cassavetes scene?
I love to do the John Cassavetes scene.